In this tutorial, we will cover upgrading Microsoft Windows XP to Windows 8. Windows XP was a great operating system, but after 13 years, on April 8, 2014, Microsoft is finally going to be ending support for it. This means you won't have the necessary security updates to protect you from new viruses and other malware. To upgrade from Windows XP or Windows Vista, you have to perform a clean installation of Windows 8. This means that you'll be deleting the existing installation of Windows XP and all the files and programs from the computer, and then installing Windows 8 from scratch. If you take this option, you need to make sure that you have backed up everything from your computer that you wish to keep. If not, it will be lost forever. Mostly. You can upgrade a 32-bit version of Windows XP to a 64-bit version of Windows 8, if your computer supports it. You will not be able to start the upgrade process to a 64-bit version of Windows 8 from a running 32-bit version of Windows XP, as this tutorial will show. To upgrade, you would need to turn off the computer and boot the system to the DVD or USB installer. Not all computers can be upgraded from Windows XP to Windows 8. The minimum system requirements are a 1 GHz or faster processor, 1 GB of RAM for the 32-bit version, or 2 GB for the 64-bit version, 16 GB of free space for the 32-bit version, and 20 GB of free space for the 64-bit version. It also requires a Microsoft DirectX 9 graphics card or greater. Microsoft makes a tool to evaluate the hardware and software on the computer to ensure it will be compatible with Windows 8, called Upgrade Assistant. First, let's make sure the computer is compatible with Windows 8 by downloading and running the Microsoft Upgrade Assistant. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter bing.com and press Enter. In the search field, enter Microsoft Upgrade Assistant. And press Enter. Click on the link that reads, Upgrade Assistant FAQ, Microsoft Windows Help. It's the second link. On the Upgrade Assistant FAQ page, scroll down a bit. There are two blue download buttons. Make sure to select the Download Windows 8 Upgrade Assistant button below the information about a Windows XP. If you get a security warning, click the Run button to download and then automatically start the Upgrade Assistant. You may be prompted with another security warning. Click the Run button. The Windows 8 Upgrade Assistant will download and scan the computer for compatibility. When complete, we will see a summary of what was found. If you would like to review it in more detail, click the See Compatibility Details link. Review the details with the scroll bar on the right. If there are issues that need further review, we can print or save a copy of the compatibility report. This is just a test system, so there is not any additional software installed on it. Your compatibility report will probably contain many more entries. Click the Close button. Click the Next button. The message says, sorry, Windows 8 isn't available for online purchase in the country region you're in, even though it is, so click Finish. Make sure you address any issues that were in the compatibility report before going any further. If you already have a DVD or USB drive copy of Windows 8, you can skip over this part. The easiest way to upgrade is to purchase a digital copy of Windows 8 from the Microsoft Store. In the address bar of our web browser, we'll enter microsoftstore.com and press Enter. In the search field in the top right of the window, enter Windows 8 and press Enter. Scroll down a little bit. We can see here both the original version of Windows 8 in addition to the updated Windows 8.1. The Windows 8 version can be upgraded to Windows 8.1 for free later. Unless you have a reason not to, you should purchase and install the newest version, which in this case is Windows 8.1. Windows 8 comes in a standard version and in a Pro version. The main advantage for the average user with Pro is the ability to use data encryption to protect your files and the ability to join a company network. For most people, the standard version is the best choice. You can upgrade to Pro at a later time by using the Windows 8.1 Pro Pack. Select the Windows 8.1 option. We'll scroll down a bit. Here it asks, how do you want to receive Windows? If you prefer, you can get it on a DVD and have it sent to your home. The quickest method is to download it. Click on English Download to make sure it's selected, and then click on the Buy and Download Now button. Click on the Checkout button. Sign in with your Microsoft account. A Microsoft account is used to sign into services such as Outlook.com, Skype, OneDrive, which was formerly known as SkyDrive, Xbox Live, and to sign into your Windows 8 computers. If you don't have a Microsoft account, you should create one. Scroll down on the page and select the Sign Up Now link. Continue on with creating the account and purchasing Windows 8. Before going any further, make sure that you have your files and programs backed up. You will need to reinstall all your applications, so make sure that you have all the boxes with the CD keys used to install them. You can use your Microsoft OneDrive, which was formerly known as SkyDrive, to back up your system before upgrading. Microsoft makes a program called Windows Easy Transfer that can be used to back up the files and settings. I will be creating a tutorial at a later date that I will link to here. After you've purchased a copy of Windows 8, follow the directions to start the installation. This is usually a link you get in an email. If you're installing Windows 8 from a DVD or USB drive, place it in the computer. Windows 8 setup should start automatically. If you insert the DVD or USB drive and the installer doesn't automatically start, click Start and select My Computer. Under Devices with Removable Storage, double-click on the drive with your copy of Windows 8 in it. Windows 8 setup shows the Get the Latest screen. The default option, which is already selected, is to go online to install updates now, recommended. This option tells the setup program to connect to the Microsoft servers and download the newest installation files, hardware drivers, security patches, and additional updates. Leave that selected and click Next. On the product key screen, enter the product key that came with a copy of Windows 8 you purchased. The product key is made up of 25 letters and numbers and is unique to your copy of Windows, like a serial number. The product key is found on a sticker on the DVD or in an email from Microsoft if you purchase it online. Enter the product key and click the Next button. On the License Terms screen, read the license agreement, and then click to select I accept the license terms, and click the Accept button. Because we are upgrading from Windows XP, the only information we have the option to keep is the personal files. Personal files are files stored in the user's folder, such as My Documents and Desktop. These are not the programs, just files stored there. You should have already backed up everything you wanted to keep on your computer, but it doesn't hurt to keep the Personal Files option selected. Click the Next button. The Ready to Install screen shows a summary of the selected options. You can click Change Selection if you want to make a change. If you are ready to upgrade to Windows 8, click the Install button. Setup will now upgrade the system from Windows XP to Windows 8. It will restart several times during the installation process. This can take 10 minutes or more on a new computer, and it will take much longer on older hardware. On the Personalise screen, we select the color combination we want as our default color scheme. Select the color by clicking your choice, and then click the Next button. If you want to go back at any point, you can press the back arrow button in the top left of the screen. The Settings screen shows the express settings that can be used to easily finish the Windows 8 setup. These are the most common settings that most users will want to use. Some people might find the default setting share too much personal information or have other objections, so you may want to review them with a customized setup. For those interested in customizing your system more granularly, click the Customize button. To reduce the length of this tutorial, we will use the Express settings by clicking the Use Express Settings button. Windows will now finalize the setup. To finish the setup, move your mouse into any corner of the screen. We are now logged into the Windows 8 computer as our old Windows XP user account. This old type of account is called a local account, and it does not link to all the new features of Windows 8. Windows 8 has the ability to use what is called a Microsoft account. A Microsoft account is what was created or used to purchase an online version of Windows 8 earlier in this tutorial. A Microsoft account is an email address that is used as your account to log into Windows 8, as well as other Microsoft services. You can create a new email address or link to an existing account such as Gmail or Yahoo. A Microsoft account allows you access to the Windows Store, where you can download apps and more. Backup data online using the storage with Microsoft's OneDrive, which is formerly known as SkyDrive, and it'll allow you to access your account from other Windows 8 computers. I have a tutorial on how to upgrade a local account to a Microsoft account that I will link to here. I would highly recommend that you upgrade your account or create a new Microsoft account. If you're new to Windows 8, you should watch my Windows 8 Beginner's Guide tutorial. I will link to this video on screen for those interested. Thank you for joining me on this tutorial. If you like the content, please subscribe to my channel or check back often for new videos.